We're talking about fall.
First day of fall is Sunday, and it will not really feel all that much like fall. Normal high temperature on the first day of fall around here is about 84.
Not bad.
We should be a bit hotter than that. I think we're around 90, not hotter than 90 degrees, over a big chunk of the state of Alabama and over much of the region, too, because we are drying out very quickly after all that rain we had just a few days ago. 73 in Birmingham right now. That live view from Regents Field. Join the Clear Sky Affair tonight from the low 70s to mid 60s, where we'll spend about the next 6 to 8 hours. And then it gets hotter. We're up to 89 tomorrow afternoon. Today, just for comparison, Birmingham, 87. So just a couple of notches higher than we were today. Here's WTM 13 live Doppler radar. The clouds that we had earlier have moved out over to the east. We can use that enhanced look at the satellite imagery to still track that big, broad area of low pressure. The same one that came into Carolinas earlier this week with all the rain and the wind and the flash flooding that happened in North Carolina. Well, it's starting to move back over toward the east coast. We've got a north wind aloft and a northeast wind at the surface. That's shutting down the Gulf of Mexico. That high, thick humidity can't back to north because of the northeast wind, so it's blocking the thick tropical humidity that would make this a whole lot rougher deal with than it's going to be. And even 90 on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, not exactly cool, but at least we're not talking about the same kind of humidity we had back in July and August at this point. Low temperatures down in the 60s for that few mornings. It does get a little more humid early next week, and we're closer to 70 in the mornings, mid-80s in the afternoons, Tuesday and Wednesday, and that's also where we're going to bring in the chance of some isolated showers. Those showers don't have anything to do with this, though. This is an area that the National Hurricane Center has drawn out in the Caribbean and the Southern Gulf, where there's about a 30% chance of tropical development within the next 7 days. Now, what that means is they're tagging about a 30% chance that something like this could form in the Gulf of Mexico. That is one computer model's opinion of how things could pan out over, say, the next 10 days or so. And that would be east of storm in the Western Gulf. Problem is, all these forecast models, they're showing us all sorts of different conclusions, including some that have this on the East Coast by this time, and some that bring it right up through Alabama. So what do we know at this point? Well, there's nothing specific at the moment, but a tropical storm or a hurricane is possible, and usually they're going to follow a path toward the north and then take a little bend toward the right as the westerly winds of fall begin to kick in. So between now and then, there's really no worries. It's just going to be hot and dry. High school football this week, the game of the week, Moody and Helena, about 81 at kickoff, 74 in the fourth quarter of that one. Hot and dry weather through the weekend, and then toward the middle of next week, we start watching what happens with this. If it goes toward the east, well, then we end up with a much cooler scenario as we move toward next weekend. If we don't, if it moves toward the west, well, then things could start to get stormy around here by next weekend. So lots to figure out, but at least for sure for the next 7 days, just like a little bit hot in the afternoons.
My golf tomorrow, off day.
Yeah.
How about that?
I think you're good shape.
Awesome.
Sunscreen.
Sunscreen?
Your friend.
I appreciate that. Hey, Bryce Young, not so good for him here on the Panthers. Bryce being benched. Will he return? Is it a Bryce?